Facing History at Ourselves is about citizenship.
It's a program that really believes that students' lives can be shaped by good teaching.
What about somebody else who was using people to perform labor who had no intention of ever paying to help them escape?
Adolescents are always thinking about, what does my education mean to me? What's the connection? And very fundamental questions about who am I? What's my relationship with other people? How do I see myself?
We are trying to really create critical thinkers and teachers who care about their students and what they teach.
Kids need to learn how to participate and how to understand where choices can be made, and adults can help them do that.
Facing History for Teacher Training is a rebirth in the teaching profession.
Teachers are just so hungry for curriculum and for materials and for support that really help them continue in their journey of staying in the classroom.
We took a lot of photographs.
I'm constantly looking for ways to become a better teacher and get better resources for them so that they can, you know, find these connections. So I think, you know, Facing History offers a good opportunity for teachers to grow.
For the past couple of months, we've been studying the details leading up to the Holocaust in Germany and the actual Holocaust.
I think the safe space at the Institute is a way to model the safe spaces that we want teachers to provide when they go back with their students.
Listen. Facing History demonstrates to students how everybody has to participate.
He's part of the problem if he's not doing nothing, right?
I think this curriculum, what it does is it teaches these kids that in fact, sometimes when you're standing in the group and somebody says get help, you have to take it on yourself to go get the help. That you have to go the extra step, that you're involved, that you it is your responsibility.
Should have did something to help somebody.
All right, look, if you had somebody, you're getting killed too.
All right, but at least you should try to see what you can do to help the situation. You should not be just sit back and watch these people get killed.
I really do believe that you have to confront history and all of its complexities. As one of our students, Raquel, said, you have to know how to learn the good and the bad.
And it's an amazing gift to give children that age.
The Facing History program has been a very traditional model. Suddenly the web emerges in the mid-90s, and Facing History has an opportunity. And by taking the training materials, the content, and a lot of the pedagogy online, the organization has been able to deliver the program all over the world.
This history doesn't belong to a particular group. It belongs to all of us. And the internet can be the place that you can help people all over the world find themselves in someone else's story. That is social justice.
What's really unique about Facing History, it is not just teaching to kids about moral lessons. It is a catalyst in the community. I am a social investor. I believe in Facing History. I support Facing History because I truly believe the work that Facing History is doing, the work that the teachers and the students are doing, will have great, enormous, positive implications now and for the generations to come.
Facing History, every time they train a teacher in 1 year, that teacher might be out there teaching for 10, 20, 30 years or more. So that money, it's really an investment as opposed to an expenditure. Money invested in a teacher training today has a leveraged impact for years and years.
The only hope really for the future are our children who have a voice and who can care for one another and who will, when equipped, be able to prevent disaster from happening, even if it's a hate crime at the smallest level.